JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 1st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other major currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It underperformed slightly only against the Aussie and the Kiwi, while it gained the most ground against the pound, the yen and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakening of the safe havens yen and franc, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, points to a risk-on trading environment. However, the strengthening of the greenback and the weakening of the pound and the loonie point otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices traded slightly in the red, though sentiment improved during the Asian session today. Maybe EU and US indices pulled back due to end of month position adjustments, or it could be what we said yesterday, that the market participants may have started trading more carefully as we get closer to Friday's NFPs. Market appetite returned during the Asian session today, perhaps due to the beginning of the new month in the continent. In any case, we stick to our guns that investors may head into the US jobs report with a relatively careful strategy as they try to figure out the next policy moves of the Federal Reserve. As we noted yesterday, expectations are for another strong report, which may raise the volume of the hawkish voices among the FOMC, something that may result in a majority vote in favor of tapering sooner than Chair Powell thinks. Yesterday, we had Eurozone's preliminary CPIs for August, with both the headline and underlying inflation measures accelerating by more than expected. However, as we've been expecting, the euro did not receive a massive boost, as an underlying rate still decently below 2% and the latest slide in the PMIs were unlikely to allow a surging headline print to alter expectations around the ECB's policy plans. So we repeat that with the ECB pledged to stay accommodative for long, we see the case for the euro to stay under pressure against currencies, the central banks of which are expected to start normalizing their respective policies soon, the like of Kiwi, and conditional upon a strong NFP report on Friday, the US dollar. As for today, traders of oil and oil-linked currencies, like the Canadian dollar, are likely to pay attention to the OPEC Plus gathering, where major producers will decide whether there is a need to add more supply now. The group agreed to add 400,000 barrels per day until the end of September, and market chatter suggests that they will stick to their guns, despite pressure from the US to pump more. On Sunday, Hurricane Ida knocked at least 94% of offshore Gulf of Mexico oil and gas production and caused catastrophic damage to Louisiana's grid. Although this could mean supply disruptions, analysts say that three quarters of that output could be resumed by the end of the week. Thus, it seems that there are more concerns that power outages and flooding in Louisiana after the hurricane will cut demand for refineries. So all this is negative for oil prices, and perhaps OPEC and its allies may want to avoid any further declines by increasing output at the moment. So we agree with the consensus, and we do believe that the cartel will stick to the existing plan. As for a market reaction, we could just see a relief bounce as even the slim chance of output increase is dismissed. Now, as for the rest of today's events, later in the day, the US ADP employment report for August is coming out, and it is expected to have accelerated to 638,000 from 330,000. Accelerating jobs growth in the private sector could raise more speculation that the NFPs due out on Friday may accelerate as well. However, we will not rely much on the ADP print, as it is far from a reliable predictor for the NFPs. Even last month, when the ADP number fell to 330k from 680k, the NFPs held more or less steady around 940k. The ISM manufacturing PMI for the month is also coming out, and it is anticipated to have slid to 58.5 from 59.5. As for the speakers, we have only one on today's agenda, and this is Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.